Good morning, everybody. In today's class, we're going to see about the challenges in online retailing. Let me introduce myself. This is Dr. Utra, Head Department of Commerce, MOP Vaishnav College for Women. As all of you know, the term e-commerce describes the process by which the internet facilitates the transactions relating to and exchange of and payment for goods and services between businesses, consumers, government, and other public and private organizations. Online retailing is a subset of e-commerce and refers to the purchase and sale of goods between consumers and retailers using the internet. Online retailing is also known as e-tailing these days. So let us see what is the situation in India with respect to e-tailing. As all of you know, India is the hub for internet facilities, considering the kind of facilities which has been granted by the government. Retailing in India has witnessed a boom which has been propelled by various factors such as increasing urbanization, rising purchasing power parity of ever-growing India's middle class, the technological revolution, intense globalization drive, etc. Let us see what is the present trend in Indian e-tailing market. Significant change in the attitude of an average internet user, the government, through its e-governance portals, have also become a rising user of the online buying. In metropolitan cities, both the consumers as well as the merchants have become equally net savvy and are increasingly finding the medium easier to conduct their businesses online. So let us see what are the, as you can see here, these are the top 10 online retail sites in India. The top online retail category is in India. Most of it is concentrating on computer software, consumer electronics, computer, hardware, etc. So let us see what are people actually buying online. As you can see, a big pie goes to the food industry, and next comes the fashion and beauty, music, entertainment, etc. So let us see what are the challenges in e-tailing. There are six factors that will determine success in an e-tailing, that is the scale, meaning how far are we able to go, what is the trust quotient, and what kind of logistics is being used, what kind of technology platforms is being used, and what is the clarity of vision, and what are the partnerships which have been taken up by the companies. So let's see challenge number one. The huge disparity between the number of internet users versus the number of online buyers is a major bottleneck which has been faced by online retailers, which means Indian consumers are not yet ready to trust and buy online. So how can this be avoided? By displaying security logos or badges. So let's see, you can see a sample here where the security badges have been provided. So let's go to challenge number two, that is the payment options, cash on delivery. So that could be an option. So challenge number three, understanding shopping behavior of different customers, because as Indians, we are a very, very diverse population. So understanding each and every sector is very, very important for the success of an e-tailing business. Challenge number four, that is, what are the advertising results? E-commerce marketing platform, a third-party vendors like eBay, Amazon, Etsy, can all be used for advertising. So this brings us to a major problem which is being faced, which is the shopping cart abandonment. Approximately 97% of the people who visit an e-site leave without buying anything. Top performing sites may get 17% plus conversion rates. The rest of the industry achieves far lesser. So why do online shoppers leave without paying? Most of it is because they are presented with unexpected costs. Like say for instance, while you are at the end of the process, suddenly a shipping cost may arise. Many people say that they're just simply browsing and not with the intention of actual purchasing, or they could have bought or they could have found a better price elsewhere in some other portal, or they find that the overall pricing is a little bit too expensive. So what happens before the cart abandonment? Reasons for before cart abandonment is presented with unexpected costs, website crashes or is too slow, price prevented in presented is in a foreign currency, which makes it a little difficult. So if the price is in local currency, it makes things much easier. So if you can show images of the products and make people actually understand about the product, it makes things easier. Other challenges and solution: test single page versus multi-page checkout. Let there be a progress bar, which makes things easier for people to understand. Cumbersome processes like registrations can be avoided. Some more aspects that can be kept in mind is offer different payment options or different payment methods. Offer support, add the testimonials, offer price guarantees and refunds. Free shipping and no hidden costs is something that's very, very important. So let's see what are the after cart abandonment. That is, you put the product into the cart, but you don't actually purchase it. So this can be taken care of by ad retargeting. That means you'll have to keep on, you know, reinforcing the fact that the purchase has been put into the shopping cart but has been discarded. So you kind of induce the buyers to actually buy it. Or you can have email recovery campaigns. So all we need to do is make the basics strong. Acquiring customers and re-engaging the customers is very, very important. Winning customer loyalty and trust should be the primary focus, and focus on the last mile, that is the logistics. This is something that's very, very important. Thank you.